C4 and Brian Neiman.
Listen wherever you are.
FM 97.9 HD2, WBAL.com, and the WBAL radio app.
We've heard from a lot of city leaders, city council people, others, as it relates to the news yesterday. Jayne Miller sitting in again today for Brian Neiman about the stepping aside of Baltimore City Police Commissioner Michael Harrison and acting Police Commissioner Richard Worley being elevated by Mayor Brandon Scott. So let's talk to a state legislator about this and how it's viewed at that level. State Senator Cory McCray joins us this morning. He's on the very powerful Budget and Taxation Committee in Annapolis. Good morning, Senator.
C4 Jayne, always glad for the opportunity.
There you go. Good morning to you.
Good morning.
There we go. There it is. So, Senator, let me ask you, Senator McCray, when you heard about this yesterday and, the stepping down of Michael Harrison, the elevating of Rich Worley, 24-year veteran in the police department, what are your thoughts?
First, Commissioner Michael Harrison's service to the city of Baltimore is commendable. What he's done with the consent decree, what he's done to be able to turn the department around is definitely commendable. And I think that he was the appropriate person at the right time to help us do that, navigate those waters. And then with Rich, I've known the acting commissioner for longer than a decade at this moment. C4, equally as you, being a legislator, you get to know the folks that are working in their respective agencies. But Rich was my major for the Northeastern police district for several years, and being able to see him on the ground, we laughed last night because we were in the backyards of some of the community leaders. But I always say, C4, and I know you know this, the difference between some and others, but Rich is like real police. When we talked about deployment, when we talked about strategy, when we talked about tactics, like from an operations standpoint, he is the right person.
What do you expect to see from him? Do you expect to see anything different with him at the helm as opposed to the tenure of Michael Harrison?
Now, I think it's an opportunity to build on what Commissioner Harrison has left us. So I do expect, like in the Eastern, we see the deployment with Major Thacker. We see police on bikes. We see them more from a visibility standpoint. He's worked within the agency for the last 2+ decades. So he has the respect of the officers from that standpoint. But being able to train and lift up these new officers that are coming in to make sure that we have the balance of quality of life, but also making sure that we treat people respectful. And I think that Rich gets that piece of it, but also from a standpoint of just making sure that the community is connected with the police department. And he was doing that each and every day in the Northeast Police Department.
Maryland State Senator Cory McCray is on board with us. And Senator McCray, you were the one in the state Senate, Delegate Conway in the House, but you led the effort to try to get the legislation that State's Attorney Ivan Bates was trying to secure in reference to gun possession situations. What do you think about the relationship between State's Attorney Bates, maybe, and Rich Worley? Because it seemed like with Michael Harrison, at least what he said yesterday, they were starting to develop a pretty good relationship, Michael Harrison and Ivan Bates.
Yeah, I think that the state's attorney and the acting commissioner are in the same posture, believe it or not, C4. I think that I enjoy working with both of them. I think that they both love our city. I think that they both want the best for our city. And at the end of the day, like, we have to make sure that the quality of life, but we also have to make sure that people are not carrying illegal handguns. And I know that they're going to try their best to make sure that they alleviate that.
But before Jayne jumps in, let me say this, though, Senator. It was obvious to me yesterday with what Michael Harrison said from the podium, there was a problem with the last state's attorney, at least in terms of getting cases and working together. And I just make sure that this state's attorney, while he worked with Michael Harrison, you think the relationship's going to be good with Rich Worley?
I feel very strong and very confident because I know both of them, and I've known both of them for a long time at this moment. And I believe that as they sit down, as they communicate, and I'm pretty sure that Rich has been in some of those conversations, probably not principal to principal, but at that time it's about to become that situation. But I do feel very confident that we're going to all be on the same page.
Senator, the legislature's had some role in public safety issues in Baltimore, and there's been this debate about local control versus state control of the police department. But going forward, do you see a bigger role at all for the state legislature, for state legislators?
I definitely do. So, like, just Jayden, just to make sure that I give the audience, I know that you and C4 know, but I've been the lead on local control, been the lead on police redistricting, been the lead on residency requirements, been the lead on police audits, been the lead on Ivan Bates' bill along with Delegate Conway. So like, public safety has to be at the crux of what we're putting forth from a state. We just wrote a letter to myself, Delegate Jackie Addison, and Kaylee Young, just wrote a letter to the new colonel because I believe that our state troopers should be working in concert with our police department. just wrote a letter to DJS because as I talk to parole and probation and I talk to my BPD, we meet every 2 weeks. But like several juveniles that were in non-fatal shootings, I needed to get an understanding if they were under his purview. And if they were, what is the after action of those juveniles? So to answer your question, I believe solely, yes, the state has a large role because we had agencies that indirectly can help impact the public safety within the city of Baltimore, which ultimately impacts the public safety of the state of Maryland.
State Senator McCray, I'm glad you brought up the juvenile part of this. And just a programming note, Jayne Miller tomorrow on her show from 11 to 1 will have Vincent Schiraldi, the Secretary of Department of Juvenile Services, on her show tomorrow. Do you feel that, you know, with the police department, because this one, I used to bring it up to Michael Harrison all the time, how is our police department dealing with state DGS, particularly with violent juveniles? Because the complaint has been, we do our job, DGS just puts them right back on the street.
Mine is that it has to be an interconnection and it has to be a certain level of coordination that happens. And we do that on a small scale on our hub within the 45th district. And that's why I'm trying to interlap DJS into this conversation. Parole and probation are on those calls. BPD is on those calls. But I know that we have a new governor. I know that the administration is 6 months plus in. But at the end of the day, like the honeymoon is over and we have to make sure that those folks are interfacing because they play a very, very important role. And you know that.
Cory, is there any interaction going on across the border? Well, I say that because we have youth violence doesn't know the border. I mean, we had an incident in Baltimore County this past week. You know, two young people shot near an elementary school, other young people charged. I'm a big proponent of more regional effort on many of these issues. Does that conversation take place so that there might be a way to have, you know, everybody kind of get on the same page about both enforcement and resources?
It does, and that's why it's a good point to bring back up, Rich. Like, we have vehicle task force that get money from the state of Maryland through the agency GOCAP, and what happens is that money is collected as a Baltimore County, Baltimore City. So Baltimore County actually gets the funds, but Baltimore City has a number of police officers that work in the connection through that grant program to make sure that we can tackle the theft and auto theft of cars from that standpoint. When you see things like the strike force, or you see a bunch of different state initiatives, this is usually an interconnection of agencies, not just on a state level, but also in your local jurisdictions. And you also see Eric Burns' shop engaged on it. So on a number of times, and usually one of the agencies that's facilitating that is the Governor's Office of Crime Prevention is usually leading the grant money that comes out from that standpoint. But as a state legislator, that's what you want to see, Jayne, because there's no invisible line to say, hey, crime stops right here at Baltimore City or crime stops right here at Dundalk. Mm-hmm. At the end of the day, like, we have to be working together because it flows back and forth.
State Senator Cory McCray, you know, I use this African proverb all the time on the air, Jayne Miller. How do you eat an elephant one bite at a time? When it comes to the multitude of problems that we have in law enforcement and everything else, with Acting Commissioner Rich Woolley, what do you want to see him do first? Like, if you had your ability to ask him to do something, what would you like to see done first?
I think that at the end of the day, C4, and you know this as a leader, you have to get out here and get into the community so people feel a certain level of confidence within your leadership. I think that you have to get in there and speak to the rank and file as this new position that you've been elevated to. And I think like that is the first step, is like you have to create that level of confidence the way people feel like they're heard, that you're accessible, and that you can hear them, and then putting forward that action plan. I believe that because he's already there, mm-hmm. that it can accelerate very quickly, and he doesn't have to do that very long. But that is any type of leader, you want to get out there, get strong, and let people see you hear them, and make sure that they feel like they're heard.
And actually, Michael Harrison was pretty good at external relations.
He was out and about. Some of the issues that had to follow through on that, people questioned that. We'll talk more about this with you, State Senator Cory McCray, when we have a chance. Okay.
No, I appreciate you both, and thank you both for your leadership and amplifying those voices.
I appreciate
Thanks.
That.